sitting there, hallelujah, amen, dormant, not doing nothing. Amen, hallelujah. My flesh is just running and doing and doing, and the Holy Ghost ain't doing nothing. Amen, hallelujah. I want that Holy Ghost to work. Amen, hallelujah. Amen, so therefore, hallelujah, I got to build myself up. Amen, hallelujah. As the word says, building yourself up on your most holy faith, praying in the Holy Ghost. Amen. So you got to prosper spiritually. Amen, hallelujah. You got to grow spiritually. Amen, your soul must prosper, hallelujah. Amen, because the test is going to get more severe. Amen, hallelujah. Amen, you got to leave elementary and go to middle school. You got to leave middle school and go to high school. You got to leave high school and go to college. Oh, and then you got to leave college and go to life. Hallelujah. Anybody know anything about life? Hallelujah. Amen. Y'all know anything about life? Hallelujah. Amen. Our young people think they got it hard because they're in school. Hallelujah, but keep on living, you'll be graduating to something greater. Amen, my oldest daughter is in college, amen, and she taught me how tough it is, amen. But she don't know that it won't be long, she's going to be facing a tougher test called life. Hallelujah. And guess what? All that schooling is preparing them for life. Amen, hallelujah. But what I have found out, saints of God, amen, hallelujah, the best way to deal with life, amen, is to have the Holy Ghost on the inside. Hallelujah. Because life brings so many obstacles. Life brings the unexpected. Hallelujah. Everything going good. Amen. In the next second, everything is going to turn all upside down. Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. Everything going good. And all of a sudden, all it takes is one phone call. Amen. Hallelujah. And change your whole mood. Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. It don't take long, hallelujah, to turn your smile to a frown. Hallelujah. It don't take long to turn your good day, hallelujah, into a bad day. Amen, hallelujah. But one thing I know, saints of God, amen, hallelujah, I know something about Jesus. Hallelujah. I know something about this Holy Ghost, amen, that's able to give you joy, amen, in the midst, hallelujah, of trouble. Hallelujah. Able to give you peace in the midst of your storm. Hallelujah. How many have been in the storm before? Hallelujah. Amen. We find, amen, that the disciples was on the ship. Amen. And the storm came up. Oh, come on, somebody. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. And when storms come, hallelujah, it has a tendency to bring fear. Oh, hallelujah. Amen. The storm rose and it brought fear. Amen. Hallelujah. But see, the good thing the world was trying to minister to us, amen, is that Jesus came walking on the water. Hallelujah. Amen. That scripture, amen, is for us to realize, amen, that in the midst of your storm, that he's there. Yeah. Hallelujah. Yeah. In the midst of your storm, well, he is there. Yeah. And it want to relay the message that it don't matter where you're at. They thought they was out in the middle of the sea. Hallelujah. Amen. See, they had left Jesus behind. He told them to go home. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. And that's to show us that no matter where you at, he is there. Yes. Yes. When the Bible says, well, he's a what? Very present what? Yes. Help. Yes. In the time of trouble. It don't matter where you at. Hallelujah. Amen. It don't matter what the situation is. Amen. He's a what? Very present here. Amen. And that was a live demonstration, amen, of the fulfillment of the word of God. Amen. That he was a very present help. Amen. Hallelujah. In their time and he will be there. Hallelujah. You may think that you have confidence, you have faith in him. Amen. Hallelujah. But if you don't really know him, the confidence and the faith that you think you have will deceive you. Even John, in his time of trouble, he sent the word back. He said, he wanted to know, is you the one, or do I need to look for another? It ain't got hot. And what you think you have, if you don't have the real thing, guess what? It's going to fail you when the time gets, when that test really gets real tough. It's going to fail you. Hallelujah. Saints of God, we need to understand the limitations of the human body, of the mind. Amen. We have ceilings. We have mental ceilings. They say a man cannot rise above his mind. You can't rise above what you think. You can't think it. You can't imagine it. You can't attain it. So we have limitations. Amen. Hallelujah. And see, if we notice from the scripture, amen. Hallelujah. God has made it very clear in the scripture, amen. Hallelujah. That when he comes in, and when he does something, everybody know he done it. Amen. He takes situations, amen, and puts you in the extreme. Look at the three Hebrew boys.
Amen.
Look how they had to turn that furnace up seven times hotter. And to prove the fact, amen, that this was real fire and real heat, the men that cast them in was killed by the heat. See, God's going to prove that he's God. So that he killed them, why he didn't kill these three young men? Now they just opened the furnace doors, amen, to let them in, and the fire, amen, the heat consumed them. But these young men walked into the fire. God's going to make it known, amen, hallelujah, when he do something.
Amen.
When they cast Daniel in that lion's den, saints, maybe we might not all realize, amen, that they had a way that they care for these lions. They kept these lions in a condition that any time anyone was thrown in, they were so hungry that they would devour them.
Yes, sir. That's right.
They fed those lions just enough to keep them alive. Y'all hear me this morning? They fed them just enough to keep them alive. They gave them just enough water that they would survive. And so when they cast somebody in, guess what? They were ready. The lions were ready. Hallelujah. They were looking at dinner. They were looking at lunch. And nobody was surviving.
Amen.
Hallelujah. But these same lions.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. They had to lay there with their mouth shut. Look at God. Look at God. This woman with the issue of blood. Hallelujah. See how God worked. He let her spend all her money going to the greatest physicians of that time. Hallelujah. Amen. To what? Find no help. Hallelujah. Amen. But what all it took was her to get in contact with Jesus. Now, I don't know about you, but I've never been healed by touching somebody's garment.
That's right.
I don't know about you. Maybe you have. I know he's still the same God.
Yes, he is.
He's still the same God. But I'm talking about without God working in it.
That's right.
But this woman, all she did was what? Touch. Hallelujah. And she was made whole.
Yes, she was.
Amen. Look at Lazarus. Amen. Hallelujah. Jesus knew why he was taking his time.
That's right.
They called for him. He took his time.
Yes, he did.
Right.
He allowed him, he allowed his body to deteriorate, mm-hmm. break down, smell. Amen. Hallelujah. Life was definitely gone. But all Jesus had to do was say, Lazarus, come forth. Hallelujah. I hope y'all get where I'm going.
Yes.
Amen. Hallelujah. We talk about soul prosperity. Hallelujah. Guess what? When you start prospering in your soul, amen, you get closer to God. The closer to God you get, the more you know Him. The more you know Him, the more you can trust Him. Hallelujah. The more you can trust Him, the more you can do for Him. The more you do for Him, hallelujah, the more you can live for Him. The better you can live for Him. The better you can serve Him. Hallelujah. Amen. So, amen, when I was so prosperous, amen, we find ourselves coming out of ourselves. Say to God, we got to get out of self. Amen. This is what it's all about, is getting out of self. This is what the Holy Ghost does. It comes to take you out of self. You done tried it your way too long. Amen. Hallelujah. And it has failed us, all of us. Amen. But when the Holy Ghost came in, it made a difference in my life. Amen. And I know it made a difference in your life. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. And so now that we have the Holy Ghost, amen, we want to build it up. Hallelujah. Amen. That we can get as much of God in us. Amen. And get as close to God as we can. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. And so as we get close to God, amen, the word of God, hallelujah, gets in us and it becomes alive in us. Amen. And saints of God, the word of God must come alive in you. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. God wants to live His life through you. Amen. We must realize that we are just a vessel. Amen. Don't think too much of ourselves. Amen. Don't get too much of yourself. Amen. We just the best. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. And whether we realize it or not, amen, we is an empty vessel. And until He fills it up, it's good for nothing.
Amen.
Amen. Well, that's right.
Glory.
We're an empty vessel. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. And until the Holy Ghost comes, it's good for nothing.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Amen. And so as we prosper, amen, in the Lord, as our soul prospers, amen, hallelujah, amen, we begin, amen, hallelujah, the transformation from self to the new you.
Amen. Amen.
Paul said in Corinthians, amen, that what, we are new creatures. Amen, that old man, that old thing, he said those things are passed away. Amen, he said the whole old thing, what, a new. Amen, hallelujah, a new you. Amen, hallelujah, how many is living in the new you? Hallelujah, how many is happy about the new you? Amen. But saints of God, don't get so comfortable, amen, that you just become so ease and zion. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. But continue to build on what you have. Amen. Hallelujah. We talk about our soul prospering. Amen. It's time that we build on what we have. Amen. Hallelujah. We have the foundation. It's now time to construct the building. Amen. Hallelujah. It's time to put up some walls. Amen. Time to put in some doors. Time to put in some windows. Oh, come on, somebody. Hallelujah. Time to put a roof on. Time to put a ceiling in. Hallelujah. We got to construct this building. Hallelujah. Saints of God. Amen. This soul has got to prosper. This soul has got to grow. Hallelujah. This soul can't just stay in one place. This soul can't get comfortable. But this soul, hallelujah, must strive. Oh, hallelujah. This soul must have a hunger and a thirst, hallelujah, for righteousness. This soul, hallelujah, it's got to have a hunger and a thirst for more Jesus. I got to have a hunger and a thirst for more word. I should be hungry to come to prayer night. I should be hungry to come to Sunday school. I should be hungry about Bible study. Oh, come on, somebody. I'm talking about soul prosperity. When you, hallelujah, stretch out on Jesus, when you begin to dedicate your life to God and to the work of the Lord, when you begin to dedicate your life, hallelujah, for spiritual growth, I'm here to tell you, saints, God begin to bless in your life. When you, hallelujah, become spiritual, prosperous, to work in your life, you began to open doors that you didn't know was even there. God began to use you in a way that you didn't know that God could use you. Three saints of God, He has given all us gifts. Oh, come on, somebody. God didn't save you to sit down on your seat and do nothing, but God saved you to work in the vineyard of the Lord. God saved us to tell somebody that Jesus saved and be blind, washed, white in the snow. God saved you to tell somebody that if He did it for me, He can do it for you. But you got to have something on the inside. You got to have a burden, desire, hallelujah, to do the work of the Lord. So when you sow, when your soul prospers, you'll be busy about the work of the Lord. I'm talking about somebody that's dedicated, somebody that's committed to God. Hallelujah. When you committed to God, you're concerned about the work of the Lord. Hallelujah. Paul said in Colossians, he said, seek those things which are above. Oh, come on, somebody. You don't have to be so concerned with the things on earth. But he says, seek those things which are above. Come on, somebody. Are you seeking those things which are above? Are your mind on things which are above? Don't let the devil get in your mind. Have you concentrated, worrying about the things on the earth? Oh, come on, somebody. The saints of God, when you prosper in your soul, when you grow on the inside, that inner man begin to grow. He began to prosper. That means he gets stronger. He began to realize that all these things that's in the earth, God got. Oh, hallelujah. It's God. God got in control. Saints of God, He told them in the book of Deuteronomy that He'd give them houses that they did not build, that have vineyards that they did not plant, that have wells that they did not dig. Saints of God, you just need to get in the well of Jesus, prosper through your soul. Oh, come on, somebody. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. He said, love the Lord with all your heart, all your soul, and all your mind. Hallelujah. With that soul, prosper and love for God begin to grow. Hallelujah. And let me tell you something about love. You can't love without giving. See, let me tell you, all it means to love the Lord with all your heart, it means you got to give God